Then the other important one is Lee that they ask all the time in the intermediate papers. It seems the revised cardiac risk index, it's all the same stuff again. High risk surgery, history of ischemic heart disease, history of congestive heart failure, history of cerebrovascular disease, insulin requiring diabetes, and your serum creatinine. Okay, this is the Goldman cardiac index, but as I say, it can basically be, you know, don't bother about it. It's, yeah. Then I'm not going to really go into optimization of patients because I think that's a completely different topic again. But the one thing that's come up time and time and again in the articles that I've read was beta blocker therapy in patients with significant cardiovascular risk factors. MEBs have kindly pointed out that for a long time it has been considered to reduce mortality, especially in patients with known coronary artery disease older than 65 and other risk factors like hypertension, diabetes and cholesterol. But then the POISE trial happened and that basically showed an increased perioperative morbidity, especially a high incidence in strokes in patients that was treated with beta blockers. So the current policy on beta blocker therapy is basically patients that's already on beta blockers stay on the beta blockers, and patients that is booked for vascular surgery will then be initiated on beta blocker therapy 1 to 2 weeks prior to surgery. Rest of the patients, doesn't matter what their cardiovascular risk factor is, we don't initiate beta blocker therapy anymore. Okay. All right, Tom, I don't know if there's anything that you guys want to add in terms of cardiovascular risk assessment. No, okay. Pulmonary risk assessment. All right, we always focus very much on cardiovascular risk assessment, but pulmonary complications is actually 2.6 times more common than cardiac complications and are likely to be much more severe than your cardiovascular complications. And interestingly, your renal complications and your pulmonary complications are the two things that's been shown to be the best predictors of long-term morbidity and mortality. Again, the use of your ASA classification is shown to be one of the best predictors of pulmonary complications. ASA 2 and greater have a 1.5 to 3.2 fold increase of pulmonary complications. Most common clinical significant pulmonary complications is pneumonia, atelectasis, bronchospasm, prolonged mechanical ventilation, and exacerbation of pre-existing lung disease. I think if you think about pulmonary complications, you really have to think from before the anesthetic, during the anesthetic intubation period, intraoperatively, and then extubation and postoperatively. You can have a whole array of complications happening in that time. Screening for your pulmonary risk factors, again, stay with basics, good history, a good clinical examination, once again, direct observation of your patient's ability to tolerate physical activity, a simple chest x-ray, and then pulmonary functions or spirometry is really only indicated in patients with known pulmonary disease like COPD, patients that smokes, and then unexplained pulmonary symptoms. Arterial blood gas can be useful to evaluate preoperative hypoxia, but it really never should be a contraindication to surgery. And then, again, the link between the renal functions and pulmonary functions, your renal functions and nutritional status have been shown to be good predictors of pulmonary complications. Albumin, with a low albumin, it's about your diminished reserve. And then, of course, your decreased hydrostatic pressure that puts the patient at increased risk for pulmonary edema. Okay, two things to keep in mind when you're looking at your pulmonary risk. So specific important risk factors in terms of your pulmonary complications is patients, COPD is shown to be probably the most important one to look at. Up to 28% of patients with COPD will definitely develop post-op pulmonary complications. Spirometry is definitely indicated, and this is one of the conditions that you can and should optimize preoperatively. With a peak flow less than 80%, you have to treat with bronchodilators and a short course of steroids. But don't forget preoperative physiotherapy with incentive spirometry, basically a pee bottle that they blow on, and lung expansion maneuvers can be